So guys, we're up for subscriber fishing today. Reports has been pretty hot. I'm gonna go out to Keystone. Out here getting some gas right now. Then check out my setup. Got this little ass John boat. And then check that guy out. Hey guys, so we just got here at the boat ramp. Just want to show you guys something. And this is the shad from this year. This year just spawned. They're all over the place. So that's all the shad. You can hear some fish blowing up on them right now. Crazy. And that's the dam up there, that's where we're going. Alright. Jeez. Sun's about to rise. Got some fish blowing up over here for sure. Hey everybody, 47 here. I'm gonna be narrating in this video because audio was not that great. As you can see here,
it's pretty well.
Slowly making my way up to the dam in the dark.
Alright,
highly not recommended. Very dangerous. So always make sure you have a life jacket on if you're ever gonna attempt it. But on this day, real hot morning, humid, fish was very active, as you guys see, blowing up, instant hookup, on flukes and topwater. I threw flukes first, but I'll eventually transition to my sofa. So these schoolies are really, really active today, and so it made it really hard to target the bigger fish, but eventually I was able to figure them out and started landing bigger fish. For sure I knew there were some big fish in here. I had some hits that they didn't hook up, but they were pretty big, like this one. Lesson learned, I was using some jig heads from eBay. Came with some really crappy hooks and that one pulled a hook on me. So, lesson learned. Buy quality jig heads. Here I'm transitioning to my surf rod. So I'm able to cast pretty decent with this setup. This is my TFO 10.6 medium heavy on my Saltiga bay jigger. It's a 4000 size. Throwing a 2 ounce modified topwater pencil popper on 20 pound braid, max quadro. So cast pretty well. It's pretty crazy again. Schoolies were super active. Try not to show all the footage here, but as soon as that plug hit the water, they're already all over it.
Oh damn, I've got to bring a tape measure. What are you? not that big. Probably around 30 inches.
This fish right here is the only good size topwater hit that I got. Everything else was really small. This guy, I didn't bring a tape measure or a weigher, but I believe this guy would have measured out at around 28-29 inches. Pretty good size fish. Probably around 15 pounds. Alrighty, as soon as it hit, I mean, as soon as you cast out there and it hits the surface of the water, they're already attacking it. And I was thinking maybe if I was reeling it in really fast and popping it really fast,
yeah, you can't throw it over there.
Getting a bigger fish and just trying to keep my lure away from the smaller guys, but they're so active that they're just bumping my lure left and right on my top part. But so this morning I brought water, but I forgot it in the truck. So after pulling in like 15 fish, I was pretty thirsty already. I just had my coffee too, so I was breathing pretty hard and I was pretty thirsty already. These schoolies weren't helping us trying to get to the bigger fish. But as you guys see my play right there, using single inline singles, and one reason I do that is because it's less damaging to the fish, and two, just right there, it's easy to release the fish and less likely to hook up into my hands. So after about 20 smaller fish caught on top water, the sun came up and I decided to transition over back to a fluke. This is a 2 ounce jig head with a fluke super fluke paddle tail. And instant hookup, but it got off. And when I was reeling it in, hooked up again. I mean, these smaller fish put up a pretty awesome fight too. So as soon as I transitioned to flukes, I started getting slightly bigger fish instead of just the little 20-inch stripers. I'm, you know, getting like mid 20s to just bigger fish. So I end up going with a even heavier jig head, and that was the key. Basically, I was just casting it over there with the heavy jig head and reeling it back at a pretty decent speed, and that was able to allow the lure to stay away from the smaller fish, while the bigger fish, they were pretty aggressive on this day. They would just come in and they were faster and stronger, so they're able to just eat up my big swim bait, and that worked pretty well. there was a lot of spoonbill and gar in here, but I was pretty lucky this day I didn't hook up to any of them, because man, they put up a really good fight, but they're not the fish I'm targeting, and I hate hooking up into them. That's why most of the time I'm throwing top water. Right here is when I decide, oh, I'm gonna transition to a heavy jig head to see what happens. And that's really what changed the game for me today, was going to a big jig head and a bigger swim bait. I was throwing a 5-inch swim bait on a 4-ounce jig head. So I do catch and release most of my fish, but on this day I did keep my first fish. I didn't even get it on video, it's already in my cooler right there. But yeah, I always tend to catch and release, unless if I needed some fish or my dad needed some fish, then I'll keep one or two. So with my surf setup, I'm almost able to cast to where that current is. So that's where most of the bigger fish are hanging out. And with my 4-ounce jig head, I was able to get into the strike zone basically. You guys see I don't set the hook right away. Like I said, there's a lot of spoonbill here. I wanted to make sure that before I set the hook, you could feel the head pumping of a striper, not just a spoonbill or something. Because they are kind of a pain to pull in, especially when you're by yourself. Those spoonbills weigh in at like 40, 50 pounds. So. Yeah. So my reaction is really slow because of that.
not a bad one.